Yeah, I was saying that. And I do not know. I'm sorry. I have to go do something. And I do not know what the issue has been that we've been asking, where I have been asking, because I own my house. I've been asking to please keep it down. To please don't put speakers out. Don't do that. We don't do that to you, so I don't know, understand the reason why you keep on doing it to us. We can easily return the favor, and you're not going to enjoy it. You're not going to enjoy your home. I do not know what the issue is. I do not know what the problem is. But whatever it may be, ma'am, you're an adult woman. I'm an adult woman, and we can work it out. So we have attempted to talk to you and ask you very politely, but for some reason, you don't seem to want to work out with us. I'm sorry, what?
I said, whatever, lady. I ain't got time for your bullshit. Just go ahead.
Do I look like I have time for your bullshit?
Okay, ma'am, I'm not going to go back and forth with you.
We've been very polite to you, haven't we? Well, that's great. I mean, that's why you maybe want to live, you know, in a decent manner.
You are no goddamn well, and you finna leave me the fuck alone. That's what you finna do.
Because
I have everybody else afraid over here, but I'm telling you, woman, you need to go sit down somewhere. And I'm telling you right now, you need to stop fucking with me.
Talking to you politely.
If I want to enjoy my life, I'm gonna enjoy.
Definitely. I want you to.
You want me smoking that crack or something?
No, we don't do any of that, ma'am. Sorry. We don't
that's
do that.
Your house. If you want to blast your music, blast your fucking music. That's your house. Mm-hmm. You pay your bills there and I pay my bills here.
No, definitely. But the point is that we being but polite, we don't do things like that. Yes, ma'am.
Whatever you're going through, I can't help you. I'm going to enjoy my life while I can.
No, definitely. I want you to enjoy it. I'm not trying to get you not to enjoy it. Because it's disrupting our life. That's why. Oh, yeah, I know. I know. It's insane. I know.
About my music.
Because it's right now, ma'am.
You're sitting up watching my fucking music, and you're taping me already. I don't give a fuck. Keep on taping and keep on taping. But you know what? Mm-hmm. My thing is, you need to stop fucking with me.
That's we're not. Really we have not. We. You don't even.
Everybody over here fucking scared of your ass, but I ain't scared of your motherfucking ass.
That's the point. That's the point. That's the point.
I'm doing my thing here.
No, that's the. That's.
This house. Uh-huh. Tell me to leave.
The what?
Leave. Until then, I'm going to do my music. My music ain't loud.
Well, it is loud enough to go into our house. That's what I'm asking.
I don't give a fuck because she got a sound wall on this damn thing.
Yeah, it's.
I can't hear shit at your house.
I know you can't because we don't play it loud.
You sitting up here watching me and listen to me.
Because you. Okay, that you're not. You know,
I can have company when I want to.
No, definitely.
And I can fucking listen to my music when I want to.
Definitely,
take
definitely.
That, you take that wherever you want to take it.
And the problem
you
here.
You need to quit fucking with me. That's what I'm saying.
Nobody, no, ma'am. You're that's the one who's been fucking with us, actually.
You're a miserable ass bitch.
You're the one. No, ma'am. You're the one.
With everybody in this cul de sac. One day you're going to fuck with the wrong goddamn person.
Ma'am, I've been living here for 30 years, and I assure you.
You're going to go to jail because...
There ain't nobody going to jail. You see, that's the point.
You motherfucking going to go to jail because you're smoking that crack and you want to fuck with me.
Ma'am, are you already making up stories and assumptions in your head? And that is not true. There's nobody smoking crack or anything like that. We...
coming from my house, in my house. I smell it.
The what?
Lady, I'm not going to argue with you.
Ma'am, you're making up stories like you're trying to claim that we unplugged. That we unplugged your things. We never unplugged anything.
Okay. You have a nice day. I'm not going to fuck with you like that, man.
No, I'm just asking if you could be...
I'm too old for this bullshit.
I know. We are too old for this.
Won't you just go leave me the fuck alone?
Okay, ma'am. All I'm asking, if you could just lower it down a little bit. Be considerate to us.
I'm playing my goddamn music. I play a lot of money over here for me not to play my goddamn music.
Well, if you play it loud, it's disrupting us.
Are
you going to put a what, ma'am?
It's not bright daylight. It's not late at night.
Yes.
It's a presentable time to play my music.
But why do you want to disrupt us? That's what I don't understand. And you slam doors and you slam gates and you slam all this stuff. Why do you do that? I'm curious. Well, I'm trying to mind my own business, but you're over here making your stuff my business, ma'am.
Talk to you no more.
I've been very respectful to you. And all this...
Please do
And don't make up stories about me.
I paid $1,300 in this month.
Wow, that's a lot of money, ma'am.
If I want to play music, I'm going to play music.
Well, the money that you pay for rent doesn't allow you to do things to violate laws.
Whatever.
Okay? That's not even the way it works. I'd be more than respectful and mindful and very, very polite to you, ma'am. So you cannot say I have not. No, I don't want you to live there. That's boring. No, you don't want to. No, ma'am. I hate those places. They murdered my grandfather in one of those places. I don't want you to go there. Please don't. I don't want. That's the last thing I want from anybody for Vage. I turn on my what, ma'am? I'm being very polite to you, and you're being very disrespectful. You cursing and doing all these things.
I live here by myself, and I'm going to do the fuck I do what I want to do by myself.
And yeah, but be mindful. If you don't mind, I mean, that'd be nice.
I want to play my music, I play my music.
Yes, ma'am, but be mindful if you don't mind. I mean, that'd be nice.
Whatever.
Just being polite.
If you wasn't so goddamn busy watching and looking and lurking and fucking with people everywhere,
I do have a beautiful life, ma'am. I do have a beautiful life. I thought you were a nice lady, actually. I thought you were a very nice lady. So, yeah, you seem like you are, but I don't know why you acting like this, ma'am.
I don't give a fuck what you do at your house.
Because you don't know what we do, right? Exactly. As long as we don't bother anybody, and as long as we don't bother you, and as long as we don't become a problem, right?
When you come fucking with me, then, you know, that's the whole thing.
Nobody's fucking with you, ma'am. You are the one who's been fucking with us, doing all the things you do. It just suddenly comes out of nowhere, and you just start doing things that is unnecessary. I think you're a nice lady, but I don't know why you're acting like this. We discuss it all the time. We talk about it. We're like, what's wrong with the lady? I mean, she's having a bad day. What's going on? We're trying to figure it out. It's not noise because you don't hear nothing coming out of our home. All my equipment is EQ'd to a point that it's not going to go outside. As we say, we're musicians. We got amplifiers. We got all the
barbecue tomorrow, and I'm going to have my music up, so you get ready for that.
No, if you're going to have a gathering, you have four of them already.
Yeah,
and you did. Did I ever complain? No, ma'am, I didn't.
And I did not complain,
ma'am.
Yes, you did.
No, I did. I never said anything. I actually enjoy your music because I like this kind of music. But sometimes, you know, I just want to relax a little more in my house, and we want to be in our living room. But with the music a little loud, ma'am, it's impossible. It really is impossible. That's all we're asking. We're not asking for very much. And please don't ever mention elderly homes. I hate those places. We have lawsuits against those places. I'm telling you, ma'am. We want you to be a happy lady. We want you to be... My mom is an elderly woman as well. She's of age. And I don't think you're much older. We just want us to be happy neighbors. Respect us, and we're going to respect you in return. That's it. You just have this really bad attitude towards us for no reason. We haven't done anything. We don't do nothing.
That's your problem.
Oh, my problem is that we don't do anything in retaliation, ma'am? Retaliating against somebody is not a pretty thing to do. God hates ugly. That's what my last neighbor said. My last neighbor, she was the great, great, great young lady. She goes, God hates ugly.
I never seen nobody old, young, old like
you. I'm sorry, what? You're a really cool lady. I just need you to please just lend us an ear and a little bit of respect. That's it. No big deal. We want you to enjoy your home. We actually like the fact that you decorate the house. We don't decorate it much, but you know, you do, and we love it. We actually enjoy it. But don't take my kindness for weakness. I'm not a weak person, ma'am. I'm just a very respectful person, and I'm mindful. I don't want you to live uncomfortably in your home. I really don't. And you being very disrespectful and rude to us for no reason. Zero reason. There's no reason. It's like you wake up one day, a few hours you're okay, and a few hours later you go crazy. It's like something happens. Like yesterday, exactly at 5:45 p.m., you started cranking up the music and you started slamming your gate and door when you were not doing any of that. You were in the front doing something. I could hear the little hammering. I said, oh, she's decorating. We enjoy it. We really do enjoy that you decorate your house for every single season. People around here don't do that anymore. And I don't understand what your issue is with us, ma'am. I really do not know. We don't do nothing. We don't play loud music. We don't slam shit. We don't come out here and stop being rowdy. We could, but we don't do things like that, ma'am. We really don't. Ma'am? Actually, no, I have, well. Well, no, ma'am, I don't have to deal with it. Because you're making your business my business. No, ma'am, you see, that's the noise. The noise. That's the problem. That's the thing that you don't want to hear. It's the noise. The noise is the one that is. No, ma'am, I'm too young to go there. I'm too young to go there. And we're not asking you to go there either. All we're asking is that you show a little more respect. That's it. I don't want to believe it's your age that's causing you to act like this. I hope not. Because that's not okay. I don't want to get to an age that I'm going to treat people bad. And I'm going to start acting up because I feel like it. That's not okay to do. You're a very active lady, actually. I like what you're doing right now. I bet you're going to look very pretty at night. I actually like all the stuff you do. I love you decorating. I love what you do. Thank you, ma'am. No, I do. I honestly do, because people, I don't know if you notice, people don't do that anymore. Young people don't decorate. They don't like it. But I think you do beautiful work. I love what you did. And to be honest with you, we try to figure out who was unplugging your little things. We didn't see anybody do anything. We kept an eye out. When you're not here, you were not here for a week and a half at one point. We looked out for your house. We rent out people. That's what we do. We take care of each other, but it seems like you don't want to take care of us. And that's really bad. You're an older lady. You should look after young people and say, you know, I'm going to teach young people how to be right people. But you don't do that, ma'am. You should be teaching us how to be when we get older. Hey, you know what? Be respectful. Be mindful. Don't treat others as you don't want to be treated. Don't do unto others as you don't want to be done unto you. You reap what you sow. You should know, ma'am. I heard you worshiping God one day. I heard you worshiping God, but then you started cussing us out. Don't do unto others as you don't want to be done unto you. What comes around goes around. That's just the way life is, ma'am. But we don't do that to you. I think you're a nice lady. I really do think you are. And if I sat there and talked to you, and like I'm trying right now, but you cussing me out, insulting me, go get the fuck away from here and get the fucking fuck. No, ma'am. I'm sorry. That's not okay. You are reflecting who you are inside, and that's not okay, ma'am. I have had people in my house and they say, wow, what's wrong with the lady? What's wrong with the lady? They say the lady. I don't allow people to come over here and disrespect unless they get pissed off on their own and they do their own thing. But I say, no, you don't disrespect people. And you sing beautifully, by the way. I heard you singing too. No, ma'am, I'm full of compliments because I think you're a great woman. I think we all great people. Oh, sweetheart, you're so sweet. I know, ma'am, but you know, okay, the thing is. Yes, ma'am. No, you know what? I'm going to let you know what it is that we do. I am, my daughter's a musician. My daughter's a musician. My daughter's a musician, and I am a jewelry maker, and I sit in my living room, and that's what I do. I work on my pieces. So it's a lot of work and a lot of focus, and when you start making all this noise, it disrupts us. Well, not really. Not really. I mean, for you, it might be lively, like, it brings you livelihood, you know, but me? Oh, no, I don't want to end up in one of those. You know, I thought you were a Christian woman at first because I heard you. I heard you talking, you know, about God out here. I heard you. But then you started cussing us out. And to be honest with you, that pulls me away from God. And I've been trying really hard to go back to that, you know, that stage and trying to get there. But you do things purposely to try to be a nuisance to us or bother to us for whatever the reason is. And I'm trying to figure that out, ma'am. I really am. Christian people should not treat each other like that. Actually, it's not loud. I see the EQ and it's the same. This lady is something. She's over.
You were just coming inside. And you could just go ahead and do your shit, man. You're trying to talk to the woman, she's not even listening to you, you know? You're being polite, you're being nice to her, and she's not really respecting you, so you know what? Just fuck.
I know, but I like to talk to people. You know how I am, I like to talk to people, so. I think you can talk to people and people will respond differently instead of doing what you want to do. So we can we come to an understanding, ma'am? Can we, like, ma'am? Oh, if we could come to an, you know, a mutual understanding and respect to each other, if you don't mind. I really don't like this.
Ma'am, I give you respect every day. You ask me to turn my music
down, turn my music down. The EQ we have shows that the music is still the same. And you're not. I noticed that. You're very youthful. That's great. That's wonderful, ma'am. I mean, you know, but the thing is that, you know, we have to come to a mutual respect if we want to respect each other and live in next to each other. Everything is pretty good throughout the week, but then one day you just suddenly start doing things, and I don't understand that. I really don't get that. And I'm the type of people, as a Latina, I like to understand what's going on in order for me to react the right way. I don't like to jump and try to, you know, no, I don't do that. I really don't like doing that. I hear a lot of decorations. I love the way you just decor. I love that. I used to do that, by the way. I used to do it when I first moved here 30 years ago, but I don't know. Life kind of beats you up and you just... I was blind not too long ago, ma'am. I lost my sight, so my hearing became very, very open. My sense of hearing, actually. Ma'am? I didn't hear you. I'm sorry. I want to hear what you're saying. Yeah, I lost my sight, and I do. I respect people. That's why I don't react the way I used to. I do not do that. I just don't want to treat people bad. I don't like that. I like to love on people, respect people. I feel that, you know, God has a way of dealing with us, and I think God just loves loving unto one another. He wants to see that. But if we start doing things to hurt others, to bother others, God is not okay with that. I learned that. God is not okay with that. My mom is a minister, I know. But, you know, I learned that through the years that I was in Christianity. I'm a little, but let me enjoy mine too. You see, that's the hand-in-hand, you know, that we can do here, the exchange. You let me enjoy mine. Mine is a little more quiet than yours because you're a wild lady. You like to have a good time. You do? Yeah. That's the problem. And I don't. Yeah, I mean, yes, ma'am. I'm sorry, ma'am, what? Yeah, but you know what? God blessed us with common sense and respect for others. You know, the word of God says you reap what you sow. And the word of God says, the word of God also says, don't do unto others as you don't want to be done unto you. Exactly, exactly. So if I'm peaceful, exactly, because I'm peaceful. Yes, ma'am, you have, because I'm asking you to please turn the music down. Let me ask you a question. If I'm asking you that that's bothering me, you as a godly woman, don't you think God is going to put it in your heart and say, yeah, I want you to love your neighbor as you love yourself? Isn't that what the word of God says? Ma'am? I do. That's why I don't make noise for you. That's why I do not do anything that is going to bother you, ma'am. I think you got it backwards. You are the one who's being a nuisance to us. No, actually, it's not before the eyes of God. It's not. And when he cuts our life short, we got to make sure that we're going to go to heaven. And we're not going to go to heaven if we treat people bad. The word of God even tells us if your brother, if something that you do causes your brother to stumble, the word of God tells you, what does it tell you? To reform yourself to your brother. It says, be like your brother. Do not cause him to stumble. And you have been doing that all this time, ma'am. You've been causing us to stumble. I have people in my house that do not want to believe in God because of the day they heard you talking about God outside that you started cussing us out. And the word of God says, do not let foul language come out of your mouth because it comes directly from your heart. I know the scripture. Unfortunately, I run into people like you and I don't want nothing to do with God. I get mad at God. You're causing people's lives to stumble. And the word of God says that that blood will be on your head. So ma'am, yes, you are causing a lot of issues. Unnecessarily. You don't need to do all that. You don't need to do it. It's not need for it. You know how to close a door. You know how to close your gate. You know how to stay silent and be patient with people. I think you're a wonderful young lady, and I wish you nothing but good living and healthy life. But, ma'am, respect us. That's all we're asking. We're not asking for nothing else. I've been here 30 years, and I respect that each and every person that moved next door. The problem is that a lot of them didn't show any respect. But they were drug dealers, and they were not really bothering me. These people were not bothering me at all. I used to be in a gang. I used to be involved with a lot of crime. And I'm going to let you know right now, I don't want to let that come out. That's ugly. I don't like that. Oh, really? Yeah, we used to live life. We used to be in a lot of things. And these people are still coming around because of the people that live in my house. Oh, really? You from L.A.? Oh, that's cool. But at the end of the day, ma'am, that's all I'm asking. I have two guys that live here. They're from California themselves. Oh, really? So at the end of the day, ma'am, all I'm asking is please just show some respect. That's all. I always got along with the Crips and the Bloods. I had them side to side. These guys hated each other. But I was able to be a peacemaker because the word of God says to be peacemakers. The word of God tells us not to be like pigs that we dancing in our own filth. We cannot be people like that, ma'am. We have to be good people. We have to be kind and let our tongues speak what's inside of our hearts. That's what the word of God says. You started cussing me out, insulting me. And all I've asked, all I came out here to talk to you, to see if I could speak to you, to see if you could, you know, lower the music a little bit. You've had your gatherings. I didn't care. I actually enjoyed it. I was like, oh, okay, she has some friends over. That's cool. That doesn't bother me at all. But the unnecessary noise when nothing is happening, ma'am, that is the stuff that we're like, please, come on, don't do that. That's not needed. And the reason we are not bothered to you is because we don't do nothing to bother you. That's the main reason we are not a bother to you is because we don't bother you. We don't do nothing to bother you. And I know there's something inside of you, ma'am, that is getting you to understand what I'm saying to you. And there's a little something inside of you, ma'am, that I know is letting you know, come on, treat these people right.
Wow, she decorates really good.
Can we come to an understanding, ma'am? To just respect one another and just be peacemakers. That's it. That's all I'm asking.
Right. That's nice and sweet. Put your head over the gate.
Ma'am?
Yeah. I'm right here. Look.
Oh, hi. Hi. Oh, hi. How you doing?
Hi, Mama.
Wow, you're tall. I'm not that tall.
Oh, I'm standing on something.
Oh, okay.
What are you doing?
No, I was just trying to talk to the lady because we have been hearing a lot of doors slamming and a lot of music.
She likes to listen to her music.
I know. And it goes straight into the house. I think she had a speaker out here or something because every time she would turn it on, you could hear it out here. And because of our windows, you know, they don't have, how do you call it, soundproof windows. You can hear it inside.
Oh, it's loud?
Yeah.
Last night.
Huh?
I was playing music last night.
Actually, to be honest with you, I had somebody in there who just wanted to return the favor, they called it. And I told him not to be, I'm on my tippy toes right now. My cows are killing me. And he wanted to return the favor because he got fed up. And I said, look, I get it. I understand. He goes, no, I'm going to do it. I said, okay. So he turned on one of the small speakers. And I said, he wanted to turn on the, because my daughter, we're musicians. And she has the subwoofers. And she wanted to turn them on. I was like, no, we're not going to budget. We're not going to do that. So I told him, I said, look, you can do whatever you're going to do right now. Get it out of your chest. I get it. I understand. Mm-hmm. It's understandable, you know?
I'll let her know, okay?
But at the end of the day, all we're asking is just that we can, you know, have a mutual understanding, you know?
Okay.
I love that she decorates. I actually enjoy it because I've seen how she decorates everything. Mm-hmm. We are very mindful, very respectful people. And we just try to live peacefully. We're going to be next to each other, you know? I mean, damn. She has
I'll
a beautiful...
Okay?
Please do.
Okay.
I appreciate it. Thank you, honey.
Thank you, Mama.